since 2002, by almost biannually basis. And so, but those data were shared inside the committee meeting. But this time, Vicky suggested me to share the data more widely to the other people. So I tried to explain to you about our results from our market study. So this slide shows the agenda of my talk today. It includes how we conducted the survey, and then I will show the latest results from our study, and then I try to summarize the strengths of improving the past results, and I will summarize the results of the survey, including some methodology how we conducted the market survey. The background organization is SAE Steering Committee for Asia, and the purpose of the survey is to understand more on the Asian market for promotion of high quality education. But the background is not the business background, but to protect the vehicle or engine for emission control. We need a proper performance or proper level of lubricant and also for fuel economy. So that is the background purpose of our study. And we interview by email basis to the major oil companies in Asia who are the member of SAE Steering Committee for Asia. And the frequency is, as I mentioned, almost once or 2 years. And we sent this type of format or questionnaire to each member of SAE Asia and asked to fill in the columns for each country. And it is composed by firstly the market demand, and then passenger car engine market in terms of quality and viscosity grade, then followed by heavy duty and also motorcycle engine oils. And this is the summary of the latest survey, which was conducted in actually 2010, but the data came from 2008, and some countries are only data from 2009. So it is practically the mixture of 2008 and 2009 data for a passenger car motorcycle quality level in Asia. It's of a motorcycle, a four-stroke motorcycle engine oil. The data are not very widely available, so I tried to summarize the past data from 2006 to 2009. So finally, I have just seven countries later concerning the motorcycle oil market. And for a viscosity grade for motorcycle engine oil, it is also quite different from Northern Asia and Southern Asia. You can easily see by the car. And this light green represents 10W40X, and the green is 10W30. And the red car is 20W50. So the 20W40 or 50, or even this is single grade 40, widely used in throughout the country. So next is the summary of the trends in engine oil market, which was conducted in the past. We made in total four times the same survey, and I summarized the trend in this chart. For example, in Japan and Korea, we can have some, let's say, the right shoulder down type slope. That means the lubricants are going to the high, shifting to the higher quality. But in some countries, like these almost not changing very much. So that means the quality of it stays almost the same. And you can see some countries have a sudden change, for example, this one. Sudden change and recover again to the previous condition. Not really the market change. As a summary, I do not explain the upper two items, PCMO and heavy duty, because I already explained in the previous slide. And just to mention about the overall, the engine oil market in Asia are widely dispersed, as you have shown in the previous slide. And high quality and fuel efficient engine oil should be promoted for environmental protection and resource conservation in the future. And this is a second summary. We are conducting some study on fuel economy, fuel efficient engine lubricant. We have a task force jointly formed by SAE Asia and JSA, Japanese SAE, which is a review of technical literature relating to lubricant and fuel economy. So we checked about 100 papers for last past 40 years from the United States, Japan, and Europe, and extracted the relation between viscosity rate of engine oil and vehicle fuel economy data. So, for example, this is the part of the report from our task force. And just in as an example, if you change the engine oil viscosity from 10W40 to 10W30, you can get 1% fuel economy. But in the case of single grade 40 to 10W30, you can even get 7 or 8% of fuel economy, vehicle fuel economy. So if we calculate based on the market data provided in my previous slide, and multiply the benefits of using 10W30 engine oil in those markets, then by country we can get expected total reduced fuel consumption like this. But in the case of Japan and Korea, already the market is below 10W30. So I just estimate when 0W20 oil fully introduced. So briefly, you can see a very big number of fuel savings achieved by using the engine oil. And lastly, I'd like to